Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. A frightening night for people in Manchester in one apartment building. Flames broke out on the third floor of this building on Croto Court at 12:30. The 41 people who live here were forced into the street. Two people needed help getting out, and they were treated for smoke inhalation. Firefighters believe the fire was caused by an overturned oil lamp. The Attorney General's office is investigating the deaths of two people whose bodies were found in a shed in Springfield. No word yet on who they are or how they died. Autopsies are planned. Another death investigation is underway in Londonderry. A body found at a home on Londonderry Road. The home was blocked off with crime scene tape yesterday evening. The death is being called suspicious. A Manchester man will spend at least 20 years behind bars for a pair of sexual assaults. Danny Paulino was sentenced yesterday to two consecutive 10 to 20 year prison terms. In late 2010, police arrested him after he trailed a woman across the Notre Dame Bridge, then sexually assaulted her. Just weeks earlier, Paulino attacked a 14-year-old girl on her way to Memorial High School and tried to take her clothes off. At his sentencing, the judge had harsh words.
I have to tell you something, Mr. Paulino. Normally, when I sentence defendants, I get no pleasure out of it, but I have to tell you, this feels good. You're a nasty little snake, and you need to be contained.
Paulino also received two 10 to 20-year suspended sentences. Tribute to fallen Greenland Police Chief Michael Maloney, 1 week after he was killed in the line of duty. Thousands of officers from as far away as Chicago came to pay their respects to Chief Maloney. The service started with a procession from the funeral home to Winnicott High School, where the memorial was held. Several state leaders attended the service, including Governor John Lynch. Also, U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder was there. While yesterday's ceremony was public, the chief's burial will be private. At the memorial, it was mentioned several times that Chief Maloney was a dedicated family man, and he was looking forward to spending more time with his family in his retirement, which was supposed to start today. Chief Maloney was one of six children, and after the memorial, we had the opportunity to speak with his three brothers. They wanted to thank the community for all of its support, and they say the farewell was fitting, nothing short of a hero send-off for their brother.
Mike lived his life to the fullest every day, and I think he would really want a true Irish wake and people smiling and laughing and telling stories.
Mike would have absolutely loved this. You know, he would have been, I mean, you know, we count how many motorcycles, 256 motorcycles, the horses, the play flyover.
Mike wouldn't want us to just be like sitting around moping. He wants us here being family, loving each other.
Now, the family says they hope the public can respect their privacy in the immediate future because they know that they do have difficult days ahead. And that's it for your morning webcast. Thanks for joining us, and we hope you can join us for more news and your weather today at noon.